The Tiger, the Panzer IV. First time we're gonna make an Academy kit. The reason I tried this Academy kit because it has a interior detail. The entire thing is detailed from the inside with removable panels. So that gave me the problem to thinking how I'm gonna build this thing. Normally I build my tanks in a diorama, heavily weathered. So I could have built, I could have built this one as a museum model, which means it is in perfect condition, no dents, no damages, no paint chips, like it would be in a museum. It's not very interesting to build it like that. So, what I was thinking, let's build this thing weathered, dents, paint chips, dust, mud, everywhere. And let's make the inside as a museum, because you don't see the inside normally when it's on a diorama. And I was going to place it next to another diorama I've made, which is a Kettencraft. No, not a Kettencraft, which is a half track. I've made some weeks earlier. So it's gonna be this in the same paint scheme. It's a Normandy 1944 paint scheme. I might even consider adding pink cushions and pink pillows on the inside of this tank, like it's in the TV series Girls in Panzers. Not quite sure if we're gonna do that. So this is what I'm gonna build. The German heavy tank Tiger 1 mid-production version from Academy, my first Academy model kit. Okay, well, been working on these axles. The instruction booklet was not very specific about these. There are actually four different kind of axles, and the instruction booklet does not say which axle goes where, and I can't see any difference in these axles. So I just glued them in. And I also glued this compartment. The reason I do this is because I need to paint the backside of the hull before the wheels get in. Because when the wheels come in, I can't reach that anymore. So I'm gonna spray it with a little coat of black. And then maybe a slight coat of the hull color before I pop on the wheels. I'm going to paint the inside as well, slight coat of matte black. So the next, this is the base coat, more or less. A very thin layer, matte black. All right, I made it a bit difficult for myself now, because now I need to paint over my fingers. Also, a very thin coat of matte black. Very thin coat. It's gonna be the shade in a few minutes of the other coat is going on. As you see, I've added a slight brownish tint to the underside, so that later when the road wheels come on, I don't have to worry about the back, because that has been painted. It's not weathered, but it's painted. Now, what I also already did was glue these things together, because, as I said, the top can be removed. However, because it's a mid production, I have to add Zimmerit all along the hull. So I better can do that first, because after they've placed the Zimmerit, you have to open all these small holes again in the back and in the front, of course, to add the detailing on the side panels. Here they tell you how to apply the Zimmerit decals. You can see in this last picture, you have to open up the holes again with a needle or any other sharp object. So I better do this first, because the entire tank needs to have that Zimmerit coating. The front, the back, and the side panels. And later on, the side panels of the turret, which are now in two parts. So I have to do that later. But this is where I'm going to go now. So I'm going to do the Zimmerit, allow it to dry, open up the holes again, and then start adding the outside and, of course, the inside details of the tank. That's for our next video.